So 2022 is right around the corner, and for a lot of people, a new year is really a fresh start and the perfect time to let go of a few bad habits. Now, I don't believe in resolutions, but I do believe in goals. So if you're looking to be better with your money, here are 22 tiny things that can help you be more intentional and deliberate with your spending and ultimately save more. But before we dive in, do me a favor and hit the like button. That contributes to my growth. And also subscribe if you like personal finance and you want to see more videos like this. The first tip is set a timer when shopping, and this is something that I've done in the past, primarily when shopping for clothes. I haven't done it very often, but definitely a few times, and basically I'll just use the timer on my phone and I'll give myself maybe 15 or 20 minutes to browse depending on what I'm looking for, and once my time is up, I'm done. Now, if I have items in my hand at this point, I might decide to try them on and then buy them, but if I haven't found anything, I'll leave the store. And by doing this, I find that I'm less likely to force a purchase. Another habit is to start keeping a picture of your goals in your wallet. When it comes to goals, it is so important that you keep them visible, because when a goal becomes out of sight, it can also become out of mind. And one thing that I do recommend doing is maybe creating a vision board. And I have a tutorial that I will link above, but along with that, it also doesn't hurt to keep a picture of your goal in your wallet, maybe next to your cash or your credit or debit card. It could be a photo of a house or a destination, it really doesn't matter. The idea is to have a visual reminder every time you reach into your wallet, which can help stop some of those frivolous purchases. Another way to curb unplanned spending is to ask yourself whether you can afford to buy an impulse purchase twice. Now, if you can afford to buy it twice, you might decide to go ahead and purchase the item, but there is a catch. Along with buying the item, make sure you also transfer the same amount into savings. Another habit is to start keeping a spending journal, and this does not have to be anything elaborate. It could be a simple notepad, or maybe you can use the notes app on your phone, but at the end of every day, write down every purchase you made that day. And this is really great for better understanding your spending habits, and it can also help you catch overspending before you dig yourself into a hole. Another habit is to keep your splurge money on a separate debit card. I think it's so important that everyone budgets for fun, because that is really a key way to avoid frugal burnout. But even if you are budgeting for it, you might still overspend at certain times. So one thing that you might do is keep your splurge money separate from your bill money. And there's two ways that you can do this. One way is to use the envelope method, where you remove this money from your bank and keep it in an envelope. Or if you don't want to carry cash, you can also get a prepaid debit card and then transfer the money that you have for recreation or entertainment onto this card. If you haven't already, you should also enroll in a Save the Change program. A lot of banks offer these types of programs, which really allow you to save money without even trying. And the programs vary. Some banks will round up your purchases to the nearest dollar and then deposit your spare change into your savings account. Or for every debit card purchase that you make, the bank might transfer a dollar into your savings. So I really recommend visiting your bank's website and seeing if they offer anything like this. And if so, you can think about enrolling. Now, if your bank doesn't offer this, another thing you can do is use Acorns, which is a micro investing and savings platform, which I will link to below. And basically, after you sign up, you can opt into the roundup program, in which case they will round up your purchases and invest your spare change in a portfolio of ETFs. Plus, you can make additional contributions into your account at any time. In the 3 or 4 years that I've been using Acorns, I've been able to save thousands without even trying. You can also add a browser extension to save money when online shopping. These are usually free to add, and once you have one, the extension will automatically search the internet for coupon codes and then apply eligible codes to your purchase at checkout, which can help you save money. Now, personally, I've been using Ibotta for several years, but there are so many other options. Options such as Capital One Shopping or Honey. Another habit is to start organizing your closet and other things before you shop for new items. In the past, I've been so guilty of buying duplicate items, and maybe some of you can relate, but one thing that really helps is just to take a moment and do a little quick inventory of what you already own, whether it's clothes or shoes or makeup. That way you can really zone in on what you need and what you don't need, which not only helps you avoid buying duplicate items, but it can also help you you save money. Another habit is to turn off autofill for credit cards. If you have a problem with impulse buying and you like to shop online, using the autofill feature for credit cards is really asking for trouble. But fortunately, if you've saved your credit card information in the past, there is a way to undo this. Now, turning off this feature will vary depending on your computer or phone, but usually if you go into your browser settings and you look for anything that says autofill options, you should be able to remove any saved credit card information or just turn off autofill altogether. And by doing this, online shopping becomes a little less easy, which can help curb some of those impulse purchases. Another habit is to start talking openly about money. If you're uncomfortable talking about money, whether it's with your partner or with your kids, make this year the year that you start normalizing these conversations. So make it a point to discuss finances with your children, the earlier the better, and also schedule budget date nights with your partner to make sure you guys are on the same page so there's no misunderstandings on how much to spend. Another habit is to review your budget every week. Some people make the mistake of creating a budget at the beginning of the month, but they don't look at it again until the end of the month, and by this time, they're already in a hole. Keep in mind that your variable expenses can change from week to week, so it is so important that you keep an eye on your budget, because if you overspend this week, that means that you have to spend less next week in order to stay on track. It's also important to check your bank account every day, and I'm not talking about anything extensive, but rather just a little quick glance over to make sure that everything's okay. This can also help you keep track of your spending, but along with that, you're also able to catch fraudulent purchases early, possibly before someone drains your account. You might also consider creating a no-spend list for the year. Basically, if you have a tendency to overspend on certain items, for the next 12 months, you agree to avoid these purchases and only use what you have. For example, maybe you're really into makeup, but you have more than enough, or maybe you love shoes, but you already have an extensive collection. So instead of adding to your inventory, include these items on your no-spend list to save money. Another habit is to set your coffee timer. If you need your coffee in the morning and you're always stopping on the way to work to buy one, one thing you can do is purchase a coffee maker with a timer and then set it up to automatically brew your coffee every morning. This way, you can grab it on your way out the door and you don't have to stop to purchase one. But don't just brew your own, you can also get a travel mug that actually keeps your coffee hot so it doesn't get cold on your commute. When running errands during the fall or winter, I like to bring along something hot so I can sip on. However, I find that a lot of the coffee mugs that I've purchased in the past will only keep liquids hot for maybe 30 minutes max. And of course, once it gets cold, I no longer want it and I end up stopping to buy one. However, last year I purchased a quality travel mug that works really well. So now when I leave the house with something hot, it actually stays hot for about 4 or 5 hours, which is perfect because I don't have to purchase one on the road. Another habit is to start meal prepping your lunch. Some people might frequently eat out for lunch because in the mornings they're rushing and they really don't have time to prepare something, and at night they're too tired. So if this sounds like you, every Sunday maybe spend an hour and start meal prepping your lunches for the following week. That way in the morning you can just grab it and go. In addition, at the beginning of each month, you can also prepare 2 or 3 dinners for your family. But instead of eating them that night, take the dinners and separate them into freezer bags and then place them in the freezer. And on those days when you don't feel like cooking throughout the month, you can microwave one of those frozen dinners and avoid takeout. Another habit is to do a no-spend week every single month. Now, some people will do a no-spend week or no-spend weekend in order to save money, and these will usually work. The problem, though, is that these are often one-time occurrences. And once that no-spend period ends, some people will go back to their old spending habits. So rather than doing a one-time no-spend challenge, one thing you might consider is doing one at least once every single month, whether it's a no-spend day, a no-spend week, or a no-spend weekend. Another habit is to only shop for groceries once a week. Now, some people already do this, but there's also a lot of people who will go to the grocery store several times a week or even daily to get what they need. But sometimes, and this isn't always the case, But sometimes there is a tendency to overspend when we go to the store more often. So if you are a frequent shopper, one thing you might do is consider scaling back to see if you notice a savings. Another habit is to check your credit. Every consumer is entitled to one free credit report from each of the bureaus every single year, but some people never check their own credit, or they only think about their credit when applying for a loan. However, checking your credit is one of the best ways to catch fraudulent activity early, which you can then dispute. Plus, checking your own credit does not hurt your score. So if you haven't checked yours this year, or you can't remember the last time you checked yours, definitely do it. You can go to annualcreditreport.com or you can contact the bureaus individually. And while we're on credit, you might also consider signing up for credit monitoring. Seriously consider signing up for some type of monitoring through maybe Identity Guard or another similar company, where basically if another company checks your credit or if an account is open under your name, you'll receive a notification. And finally, get into a habit of negotiating your credit card rates. Some people don't realize this, but credit card rates are negotiable. So if you have a good payment history with your creditor and you're trying to get out of debt, call them up and ask for a lower rate. Now, this doesn't always mean that you will get a lower rate, but quite often some companies will lower your rate on the spot, and owing less interest means that more of your payment will then go toward reducing your principal balance. But keep in mind, in order to benefit the most from a lower rate, you must continue to make the higher payment. That's all that I have for you guys today. I really hope that you enjoyed this video, and I hope that you're able to use at least a handful of some of these habits. Thanks again for watching this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and share, and I'll see you in a few days.